Mortal Kombat 1 has a ton of content, and from what it looks like, the new Invasion mode is where the bulk of it is going to be. Invasion mode, brand new to the series, is an interesting new take on what has traditionally been the Crypt, where players unlock various skins, fatality codes, concept art, etc. Being an amalgamation of the Crypt, along with other big Mortal Kombat mainstays like Test Your Might and Test Your Strike with a coat of RPG paint, this is the new single-player mode that NetherRealm Studios has been teasing all these months, a mode that we are going to dive in detail right now. If you're interested in playing MK1 early with the Premium Edition, go ahead and enter my giveaway of the Mortal Kombat 1 Premium Edition linked in the pinned comment and in the description. In a recent interview with Games Radar, director of Mortal Kombat 1, Ed Boon, and lead designer Derek Kurtzik explain what this new Invasion mode is all about. Ed Boon begins by saying Invasion mode is, quote, a greatest hits of Mortal Kombat single-player experiences, end quote. Looking at the footage here of the first few minutes, we can see what Ed is talking about, seeing as there are numerous singular fights, fights with various modifiers like armored enemies or having projectiles hurled at the fighters, to Mortal Kombat mainstays like Test Your Might and Test Your Strike, to new minigames like dodging obstacles in a bullet hell-like format where the survivors obtain their rewards upon completion, and so much more. And speaking of rewards, there are a lot on offer in Mortal Kombat 1's Invasion mode, and they run the gamut of character skins, palettes, and other cosmetics, to unearthing new fatality codes, to unlocking concept art, character renditions, and more. I think of it as a combination of a number of modes, says Ed Boon. It has elements of the Towers of Time, Conquest, some of our single-player experiences that we've had over the years, Crypt, and all that, that we wanted to kind of combine in there. And I describe it as a gigantic board game that's as big as many city blocks that the player is kind of advancing through with challenges, with towers, and it is probably the most abundant place to get rewards, to get skins and palettes and all that stuff like that in the game. Upon looking at this footage, it's hard not to look at it as if it were a board game, right? I mean, we have our character standing on nodes, able to move around a play space by following a dedicated path at right angles, with each node containing various challenges, mini-games, or rewards. It's hard to not see comparisons to something like Mario Party in the aesthetic here, or something like Super Smash Bros. Ultimate's World of Light mode. But Invasion mode has a bit more layers to it. While it may appear like a board game on the surface, there is a light coat of RPG paint that differentiates itself from other board game-like modes out there. Players are able to choose one main fighter and a cameo fighter across any of the maps, of which the fighters may be changed at any time. Every fighter has 5 base stats, including health, attack, special, defense, and agility. Upon leveling up your character by completing battles and challenges within Invasion mode, you will be given a number of stat points where you can allocate these points to increase your parameters. You have the option to allocate the points yourself or let the computer do it for you. In addition to that, there are 10 different elements in the game, and your equipped gear may affect the resistances or buffs associated with each of the elements. These elements include acid, blood, chaos, dark, electric, energy, fire, ice, magic, and physical. Each fighter can equip one talisman and one relic, with relics boosting various stats, and talismans being items that may be used in combat to fire projectiles, power up your attacks, heal your character, and more. This footage here shows Sub-Zero using a flaming nether skull talisman that allows him to shoot flaming skulls at his opponents. As you would imagine, this attack deals fire damage on a hit, so if you know your opponent beforehand has weaknesses to certain elements, it might be quite the good idea to try to exploit their weaknesses to get the upper hand. These talismans also give rise to a lot of interesting blends of elements, like Sub-Zero again, as he employs ice abilities but can be configured to use fire in addition to his native ice elements. Even though these RPG mechanics may not seem like much right now in this early game footage, I wouldn't be surprised if we see build guides sprouting up all over the internet to tackle some of the mode's toughest challenges in due time. Before we move on from the talismans, it should be mentioned that talismans are a consumable and can only be used a finite amount before needing to replenish them at a forge. Talismans can also be upgraded at the forge. So yeah, that sounds like a lot for a Mortal Kombat mode with all the RPG elements added in different configurations that can be customized for your favorite fighters, right? Let me know what you think about the RPG mechanics in the comments. Lead designer at NetherRealm Studios, Derek Kurtzik, explains that Mortal Kombat 1 is chock-full of incredible single-player content, referring to Invasion Mode as the game's secondary campaign of sorts. We have, of course, our amazing story mode that we've had in game after game, and it's just an amazing, cinematic, wonderful experience, says Kurtzik. But then on top of that, we also complement it with Invasions. Invasions is a single-player, RPG kind of light-based experience throughout the different realms of Mortal Kombat 1. You level up and you have multiple different challenges and opponents to overcome while leveling up and getting stats and having elemental opponents. And then there's talismans and relics and forging and shops and secrets and... it's ambushes! It's just something completely new and different than we've ever done before. It's really something you can do on your time, and it's gonna save where you're at, and you can pick it right back up and complete your journey throughout this realm. While many fans of Mortal Kombat have always dreamed of having something like Mortal Kombat Deception's Conquest mode make some sort of return, to me, this seems like somewhat of a spiritual successor to that game's mode, where, while although much more restricted to moving around these realms and play spaces, gives us a deeper look at each of the game's realms and levels. The opening area of Johnny Cage's mansion is a perfect example of that, by giving us an idea of what Cage's house is like, as the stage only gives us a very limited idea of his house. We see his personality shine through in the little details, with him having his own game room and small theater, living spaces and the like that expand on his personality. Players can zoom in and rotate the camera to soak up all the cool details. And yeah, I know having a new style of conquest mode like an evolution from the one in Deception would be really cool, but I'm actually really excited to explore these boards across the realms, finding its Easter eggs and secrets that give us better insight on the characters living within them and also the awesome stages we fight in. There will be a main path to get to the end boss, but the developers have said that there are numerous branching paths where players can explore to obtain more unlocks and secret areas. It also helps that almost all of the text is voiced by the Mortal Kombat 1 cast for increased immersion.
Sweet! You found the key! But you're also gonna need the pin for the security system.
One thing to note is that the Invasion mode is constantly updating with a major update rolling out every 6 weeks and contains tons of endgame content for players to continue unlocking rewards. So what you do is you basically go through the progression of all those islands of what we call the Golden Path, continues Kurtzik. Once you defeat the final boss, Scorpion, for Season 1, the Invading Force, then you can go from Z back to A through endgame content, using all the tools and things you've unlocked or acquired or whatnot through your journey. And then after 6 weeks, we shut it down and we bring back a whole new experience, a new invading force, a new mesa, different pathing, different rewards, different bosses, all of it. A new experience for another 6 weeks. Kurtzik was quick to dispel any fears relating to battle passes, saying Mortal Kombat 1 does not have battle passes, so players worried that they need to spend real money on accessing the new invasion seasons don't have to worry about that. Seasonal credits can be unlocked and can be redeemed to unlock cosmetics, which may be referring to the Dragon Crystal's currency, the in-game currency where players can spend real-world money on cosmetics in the form of microtransactions. I'm really curious about the invasions, and I'm curious how much the mode will change after each season. We have confirmation that there will be new paths and different routes, but will this also mean new areas and boards may be accessible as well? This is definitely one way to keep players invested in the game long after the game releases, and I look forward to seeing if invasion mode evolves throughout the years of support coming to Mortal Kombat 1. With the Combat Pack coming out shortly after the game releases, in addition to the inevitable Combat Pack 2 to follow, it would be awesome to see how Invasion Mode incorporates the additional roster, if it does. So, with all that said, Invasion Mode contains a lot of fights, a lot of modifiers, tons of mini-games, lots of loot, secrets, and boards to roam, all coated with light RPG dusting that updates several times a year to keep players returning for more. Does this sound good to you? Let me know in the comments, and make sure to participate in my Mortal Kombat 1 Premium Edition giveaway for a chance to play the game 5 days early on September 14th. Watch this video if you want to learn more about the Lin Kuei and why they are such a deadly clan. Thank you all for the awesome support, and I will see you real soon in the next one.